Yes, man, share the life, share the life. Today's a special day, blessed day, no? To bride and groom. You can share the link, see? Got three people online already.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, you can talk. You want to say something?
Yeah, man. Good, I'm good, you know?
So watch out, yeah. Your work.
Back to you, blessed love.
Ladies and gents, afternoon. You're all live, so don't be shy. Open up, come on, shy. Yeah?
Yeah.
Feel free to talk. You're watching me live on YouTube, yeah?
Oh,
yeah.
I have some.
You all look stunning anyway, so ladies and gents, yes.
Hello,
hi, how
are
you? The battery are right. You're watching me live.
Hello?
I can see America, Jamaica, all over.
Okay.
So if you want to give me a shout out, you know, in regards to the bride and groom, anything.
Thank
somebody
you.
Back home, you know what I mean?
Shout out to my mommy. Shout out to my mom in Jamaica. Angie's gonna miss you because you know you're her first cousin, and it's pretty you couldn't come to see your cousin getting married today. But I'm here for you to support you.
Good afternoon.
Hello.
You're streaming live, yeah? So
hello.
You might see even your family and friends here and see you. They saw you.
Okay.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I like that pink.
Thank you.
I love the color.
I'm not that pretty,
thank you.
What for it about?
And the best man.
Yes.
Italy.
It's like shaking. Greece. Yeah, no, I'll try to get somebody to tell me the person in church so that we can share the link.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody
might have.
What about you? What about you? Never know that.
Or further than that.
That's a reasonable.
Go.
Share the life.
Of course, let me send it to your WhatsApp.
Yes.
And then we can share.
Yeah.
Yeah, good to see you, sister.
I'm sorry, I've been blanked. They weren't intentional. I just can't see it.
And I ain't got no glasses. Yes.
What's your dad about? They're
coming
up
They should be here.
Okay. Hello. All the best, Richard and Angie. It's going to be a good one.
Come through with us.
Yes, ma'am.
She says, what's the live feed or something?
Lionfoot TV.
What?
Lionfoot TV.
What's that mean?
Lionfoot.
I love that. Can't forget the name.
Breeze, Angelique, enough love. You know you're blessed by God already. Pure love, Byron, yeah?
Alright. You're alive,
huh?
If I come out of it, it's gonna. So you go on YouTube. This is the music YouTube is. Is this a music one? Sorry about that, peeps. I was sharing, helping someone to find a live. You know, share the live, share the live, share the live.
Yeah.
really appreciate you coming, brother.
Yes, man. Happy for you, man.
Is it?
Yeah, blessings. Blessings.
Long life and hope and blessings for man, you know?
Every time.
Yeah. Long years, that's it. Yes, man.
Blessed love.
Long years with a man, you know?
Yes.
You know?
Yes. When I grow big, I want to be exactly like you.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
I think it's best for Mr.
And there's something you know, just like, you can leave the sand over there, but yeah, I know you're doing it. Like, anyway, you can get the shots, but just work as a team. That's a rhythm, but it's gonna move and go somewhere else. It's gonna operate. But if you catch us sometime, you know, you can't avoid us on it. But try not to focus on us.
Hello, Mom.
That's my mom.
My lovely mom.
Lionfoot TV.
Yeah. Yeah. You want to subscribe to the video?
Yeah, my brother.
Who's that person?
Sorry?
Benin.
Oh, okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
That's a good thing.
Beautiful day.
Sorry for
that. Yeah,
I'll see you a little later.
All right, I'll see you later.
Yeah.
You back it.
Yes, my general.
Are you all right?
Mm-hmm.
All
right. Sorry.
Right.
I'm sorry. I'm going to find it from the bride.
Just
Just one question, please. How are you doing?
This is what you're going to do with it. It's when you're coming on the aisle, you can't walk in front of you. The crit will go wrong. When you come in, the crit will go around, catch a back way, then you go on the and try to fit into a space. I'll make people at the main channel come there. Okay. Pastor, how are you?
And? Hey, good man, all is good.
And? All the best. And? I got a camera. But it's going to move.
Smiling in the front as well.
As soon as the bride gets up.
Yeah, that's you.
Don't
post anything up.
Yeah. Perfect.
Share the life. Subscribe and click the bell. Welcome to Lionfoot TV. Over here, so we keep it real on the back of you. As it, we will cover every matter, every issues, debate, sports, crime and violence, bone crime, no? But today is a special day.
Thank you.
child here today, huh? Angelique and the child. Everyone looking lovely, stunning. Let's go watch the ladies and looking very good. Yeah. Big up anyone back home, to the bride and the groom.
Yeah.
Anything you want to say?
May the Lord watch between the both of you and be ready for when he comes.
Thank you.
Amen.
How long have you anything you want to say?
I'm happy to be here. My son's celebration, wedding, and as a family, I'm here as his mother. Happy to know that I'm able to come, and we are going to enjoy every moment of this time. God bless you. Yes.
I can't wait for one of those.
Yes, my G. You can shout, yeah? Thank you.
Hello? Mm-hmm. Say hi. Hi, Anch.
I think what he's saying to you, senior at family functions and stuff.
Yes, it's better. Well, I'm glad you didn't work for the police.
Let me look
in your pockets.
Yes. Turn them over.
Thank you. Thanks for the compliment. Yes, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the fact that we
I've done a lot of weddings in my ministry, but this is the first time I've seen such a beautiful smile. Even though Richard couldn't believe it. On behalf of the bride and groom, Richard and Angelique, we'd like to welcome all of you here to this very special occasion. I'm certain that your presence here this afternoon brings joy to their hearts. And maybe that's part of the reason why when Angelique saw that lovely audience, she smiled so beautifully. We give God thanks for this holy institution that's called marriage. And we pray today that as they both unite their lives together in holy matrimony, blessings will follow them. We pray that the Lord is going to bless them with good health and long life,
yes,
so that, yes, they will enjoy their marriage for a long time. We also wish them Godspeed, and may they be the best example that others can look for in a marriage couple. There are many failing marriages around us, but we don't want you to look at them. We want you to look at the successful ones. And so we want you to live in such a way that those who are married would always remember this special day, and those who are not married could be motivated to take the step that you have taken today. So in a very special way, we welcome all of you here to this very, very special occasion where you will witness the marriage of Richard and Angelique. There is a hymn that would be done now, so we are inviting the hymn.
Thank you. Remain standing for the prayer. You could just remain standing for the prayer. It's important that we start this ceremony with prayer. Shall we bow our heads? Our Father and God, we give you thanks for this very special day where Richard and Angelique can join hands together in holy matrimony in the presence of relatives and friends and loved ones who have come to support them. We invite in a very special way your presence to be here. May your glory condescend and fill this space, so that as we go through this program together, you will be well pleased, and each person will sense the nearness of your presence, not only with Angelic and Richard, but with each person here today. So, Father, we invite you to come and do something with this wedding that no human being can do. We are only as channels to convey the blessings to the bride and groom. So we ask in a very special way that you will come and put a very special blessing on this occasion. Now, as they unite their lives together, we pray that you will bless them in a very special way. Remember those who have been married before. Today I just pray that you will bless them too. May you help them to renew their commitment, spouses to each other. And so we thank you for giving advice in our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You may receive. I believe each one of you who has to participate in the program, we have one of these in your hand. So just look, just follow where your name comes, and as soon as the person that is before you does what he or she has to do, the next person will be you, so nobody will be calling you. Have I made myself clear? You didn't hear me. For those who will be taking part in this program, we will not be calling you. Just follow the program. Thank you very much. So the next person on the list is the scripture reading.
Dear children, let us not love with words of speech, but with actions and in truth. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. But Ruth replied, don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God my God. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you.
that as the journey lengthens, the experience becomes sweeter. It becomes sweeter. And so, to make this experience such an amazing one, you both would have to take responsibility for the happiness and the joy of each other. You both will have to do your part. Richard, you know, one of the great writers by name Benjamin Franklin, this is what he said. He said, before you got married, you had to keep your eyes wide open. But after the wedding day, you've got to keep it half shut. So there might be times when you might have to close your eyes to certain things. And Angelique, there would be times when you'd have to shut your eyes too. You both would have to learn to choose your battles. Which one to fight and which one to leave. Because it is so important in marriage. So each of you would have to make sure that you are looking after the interest of each other. Today also, you have entered a school, you have entered an institution for which comes no graduation. Nobody graduates from marriage. So you both are now enrolled in a very special group that's called husband and wife. And it's something that you both will have to stick together to make it work. One writer, this is what he said. He said, the secret of marriage, or the secret of a happy marriage, remains a secret. What he's actually saying is that what would be responsible for the happiness in my marriage may not be the same thing that would be responsible for the happiness in your marriage. So it's always a secret that you have to try to find out yourself. But as you exercise kindness, and as you exercise love, and as you exercise, as you demonstrate this wonderful personality that both yourself, Richard, and Angelique demonstrate, I believe that you are going to find the key to the secret, the key to unlock that secret that opens up to you the joy and the happiness and the peace and everything that the marriage needs to make it a happy one. As you strive to make your marriage a happy one, there are some foundational blocks that I want to present to you. Marriage is not a work. But with Christ, you can make it. At this time, I want to just pause and ask you in the congregation, those of you, if you're sitting close to your wife or you're sitting close to your husband, I'd like you to take his hand in your hand. If you're not sitting close to your wife or your husband, I'll give you an opportunity. You can get up and move close to her. All right? This is a wonderful day. We want people who have already been married to recommit their marriage in heaven. Thank you very much. So there are some foundational blocks that I would like to present to you. And the first one is, make Christ the foundation of your marriage. Keep him in the center of your marriage at all times. You see, you may think your love to others that might be so, but there are challenges that come sometimes that may cause you to think otherwise. So I want you to look at this building. You would see that this building is made up of thousands of bricks. What would you think would happen to this building if the bricks were sat one on the other? It would crumble. When the windows, it would crumble. There is something in the little bricks, you see a very thin line, and this is called mortar. The mortar is the substance that holds the bricks together. Without the mortar, the bricks will collapse, the building will collapse. With the mortar, as strong as the storm may blow, the bricks will not move because the mortar, as thin as it appears, it has a strength that can resist the power of the wind. And I'm saying this to you, and to encourage you, I like bricks. Just put you together without Christ, you crumble already. But if Christ, if you give Christ an opportunity in your life, Christ will come like the mortar that will hold the bricks together, and then come what may, whatever breeze may blow, your wedding, your marriage will not be affected. So make Christ the center. Ask him for wisdom. You would need wisdom that no human head could give you. The children, by the way, I grew up in Caribbean, so I learned all the good things, all right? And one of the things I learned in school, and I'm certain that some of you may have learned it before, it says, two heads are better than one. You ever heard that before? But you know something? In marriage, two heads are as dumb as one. In marriage, two heads are as dumb as one. You need a third head. And that third head you need is Christ. No one else. Not mom. Not dad. I'm not saying you should abandon them and don't keep them in your business. But the third head that you need to keep your marriage together is Christ. So make him the center of your life. Make him the center of your plans. Give him a place in your heart and in your home so that he can continue to hold marriage together. Secondly, you need respect. The second part is respect. Don't you ever think that because you have gotten her or she has gotten you, you can lose respect for each other. In fact, one of my favorite writers says, anytime respect is gone, love does not stir up. So you need to respect each other. Angelique, as hard as you may try, Richard will never become Angelique. And Richard, as hard as you may try, Angelique will never become Richard. So you've got to learn to appreciate the differences that you have. Angelique, you would always be Angelique. Richard, you would always be Richard. There are some things that you know, we can meet in the middle. And there's no problem with that. But never try to convert each other into being you. Alright? So respect. Always respect each other. Always respect each other's rights. Whenever you have to discuss anything, make sure that respect is one of the things that you would stress in your discussion. We need to respect each other. So the second thing. Third thing is your communication. Communication is one of the things that causes so many marriage to crumble. Not only marriage, but communication is one of the big hiccups in relationship today. And you've got to learn to communicate with each other. It is often said, Angelique, and I'm certain that you would have discovered that in religion, it's often said that men don't talk much. And sometimes, Sometimes men believe that women are too descriptive. No, you never, don't ever make a mistake and say, Angelique is talkative. Huh? Don't you ever make that mistake. You can say, Angelique is quite descriptive. All right? But, so Angelique, you know, it is said that men don't talk much. So you need to find a way to make Richard talk. All right? And in so doing, you don't ask him close-ended questions when his answer is yes or no, or you know already. You ask him questions that would make him see. So you would never ask him, really, this is what was said in the inquiry, isn't it? Communication is very important in a marriage, all right? It is one of the biggest hiccups in a relationship. So please remember, you both need to communicate with each other. Richard Angelique is not a mind reader. So if you have anything in your mind, say it to her. Angelique, Richard doesn't read mind neither. Right? So if there is something that is bothering you, find the right time and find the right place, but discuss it with respect. Remember, all you do, discuss it within the context of respect. Even when you didn't agree with each other, there's nothing wrong with that. Richard, if you like red, and Angelique, you like green, there's nothing wrong with that. You like blue, yes. You know? So there's nothing wrong in that. Angelique may not like the color you like, but this is her right to choose whatever color she likes. So remember, communication is essential. It is critical in your marriage. So as you establish your family, make sure you have a place at home where you can pray with Angelique, and Angelique can pray with you. Morning and evening, let me tell you this. There's something that is called death. You ever heard of death? Death sometimes don't give anybody a warning. You would not want to know that Richard leaves home this morning, you didn't even have time to pray with him, and death shows up. So make sure that every morning before you leave, if you have to leave home 7 o'clock, try to wake up a little earlier so you both can have a prayer. You both can ask God to take charge of your life as you are away from each other. You both can ask God to take charge of your marriage and keep the sweetness and the happiness and the joy going there. There's only Christ in that. So you both need to take time to pray. Alright? So, as you unite your life together, the Bible says you both become one. And what does it mean? It means that there is an infusion, and there is something that holds you together, so that if Angelique's head hurts her, Richard, you begin to feel the pain too. If Richard is upset, Angela, you begin to share the same emotions as well. There should be no abuse of any kind in the relationship. In fact, it is my advice to you that you set boundaries to govern your relationship. And one of the boundaries should be no abuse in marriage, be it physical, or verbal, or psychological, there should be no abuse in marriage. Because if you hold up your finger and take a machete and cut it off, you will feel the pain. And because yourself and Angelique, your wife, she experienced it well. So you should not at any cost do anything to cause her pain, or she should not do anything to cause you pain. You should be looking after the interest of each other. Forget about yourself. This is Angelique's business to look after you. Angelique, forget about yourself, because this is Richard's business to look after you. So think about it. If Richard is looking after you and he's doing his best, and you are looking after him and you're doing your best, wouldn't you be a happy couple? You will be an extremely happy couple. So, the Bible says it will become something. I've never seen a head alive by itself. For a head to be alive, it must be connected to the body. And so if you're the head, the wife is the neck. Angelique is the neck that connects you to life. Learn to appreciate the gifts that each of you have. So even though you, the Bible says, the husband is the head, it does not mean that you ought to take advantage of her. In fact, Paul says, in the book of Ephesians, Paul says, wives, Angelique, submit yourself to your husband, Richard. But Paul says, and then Paul said, Richard, love your wife. Now, the more you love her, the more you love Angelique, the more willing she will be to submit herself to you. But if you are a hard taskmaster, she wouldn't. And she will have every right not to. So love her and treat her well, and you will get everything you want. You will need my class for it. Alright? Then the Bible talks about roles. Angelique, in spite of what you do, you will never become the head. Because this is a position that God has given to the husband. You might have a better job than him. You might work for more money than him. That does not make you the head. Because headship is given to the husband by God. So, Richard, be wise. Be wise and be able to harness the talent that she has. And so with both of you coming together, your life is going to be a happy one. So as you embark on this journey together, as you embark on this journey together, you are to share life's joy and life's sorrows together. They will both. Life will bring some joy, and then time will bring some sorrow, and you have to share this together. Share it together. Right? You are to discuss together your fears, your hopes, your expectations, and your anxiety. And that's where you have to get into learn to talk. Don't be afraid. Your wife is supposed to be your closest friend. Expose yourself to your wife. Tell her what is in your heart. Tell her your fears. Tell her your hopes. Tell her your anxieties. Tell her your expectations. Both of you. Angelique, that's what you need to do. Tell him what's in. Tell him your hopes. Tell him what you hope for the future. Discuss it together. Love follows people all around the world. Love brings people together under many different circumstances. I believe God's providence has brought you both, Angelique and Richard, together. And so the love, Angelique and Richard, the love for your heart, that you have for each other, is one that should seal the marriage vow and that you will share for all eternity. This love makes burdens lighter. Why? Because you share them. You're not carrying the load all by yourself. You're not carrying the riches. You're not carrying the load all by yourself. The love that you have makes your burden lighter because you share them. All right? It makes you stronger because you're able to reach out and get involved in life in ways that you cannot risk on your own. And so Richard and Angelique, as Christ loves the church, so you ought to love each other. As Christ loved the Father, Angelique, so you've got to love Richard. No man is expected to love more than Christ loved, or to obey more than Christ obeyed. The greatest philosophy of the whole scheme of this universe and for the home is to love even as Christ loved. Hearts that are filled with love, with the love of Christ, will never drift apart. So as you set up home together,
Be sure that your home is a warm place, so that whenever your parents come in, or your siblings come in, or your friends come in, they can feel the warmth of your love and they can say, "Richard, boy, I really hope that my home could be like that." Make sure that your home is a warm place, warm with the love of both man and wife, warm with God's love, which is the source of all right motivation, warm with friendliness for all who will come back, warm memories of the past, warm hopes for the future. Let your home be a protection against the blasts of the enemy. Let your home be a shielding warmth against the chilling draft of a cold, hard world that could kill us. But remember, as I close, remember, a home like this doesn't develop by chance. It takes planning, hard work, and so it should be a constant study to plan and to conduct your home after God's design. Avoid everything that creates contention. Keep unbroken your marriage bond. And as you weather life comes together, you can say, "Richard," to Angelique, and Angelique to Richard, you can say, "I love you, not only for what you are, but what I am when I am with you. I love you, not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for ignoring the possibility of the foolishness in me and for laying hands firm hold on the possibilities of the good in me. I love you for closing your eyes to the discord in me and for adding to the music in me by your attentive listening. I love you because you're helping to make of the lumber of my life not a shaft, but a temple, out of my efforts, not a reproach, but a song. I love you for the part of me that you bring out and have drawn out into the light all the beautiful things, the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked so far to see." And so, Angelique and Richard, into this holy estate, I now invite you as you both become man and wife. My question to the audience is there anybody here who can show just cause why these two, Angelique and Richard, may not lawfully be joined together? Well, let him now speak, or else forever. Else forever, hold your peace. Is there anybody who is going to be who want to object to wedding? All right, their hearts are coming, but it's all right. It's okay. All right, good. So, Angelique and Richard, I will now ask you to come. If you can stand and come close up. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm saying to Angelique and Richard at this time, I require and charge you both as you shall answer in the day of judgment. When the secret of our heart shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any cause or impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in my family, do not confess it. for being well assured that any who are coupled together otherwise that God would not love, you are not joined together by God, neither is this marriage lawful. Is there any impediment that you may want to? No, there is no. Richard, I want you to hold my hand. I'm going to speak and I want you to repeat after me. I'm going to keep slowly. Pull up the microphone. The part is coming a little bit, but I don't know what's happening. I have to be close to him. Let me go for it. And, right? So I'm going to speak slowly and I want you to repeat after me. Now it's important that you repeat after me so that the witness is there. Alright? I do solemnly declare, I do solemnly declare that I know not, of any impediment, why I, Richard Francis, may not be joined together in matrimony. To Angelique.
Keep yourself only unto him as This is the last one. This is the last one. So raise your hand if you have one. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present
to witness that I, Richard Francis,
and I, Richard Francis,
do take you, Angelique, to
I take you, Angelique, Antonio,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better. Child, I paused like a child.
Yeah, the phone are charged, same time I can't move on. Bear with me, the phone I get some juice.
Ladies and gentlemen, this couple is now leaving. We now invite the those with the ring bearers to come forward, please. Photographers, make sure you position yourself. This is one of the million punks shots that you don't want to miss. I would now present to you the newest, the most recent wedding couple in all of South London.
Big one.
One more to go. Yes, now. Now, you know, if you purchase a property, there is something that is called the deed that you must have. The deed gives you the entitlement to the property. Yeah. And so today, the 20th day of August, 28th day of August, 2022, I would like to present this, the title deed of this marriage, to Angelique.
Yes.
May God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is really a blessing to be here. And I remember the first time I met Angelique, she just came in to have a look. We didn't know each other. And she said to me, I want you to marry. And I told her, I said, listen, my tenure at this church is going to end in December. She said, I don't care. Would you come back and marry me? And I made her the crown. And so today, I'm very, very pleased to show her. Congratulations. Wherever I see you, I want to see my oil coming to the door. All right? There we go. God bless you.
You don't have to. I'm there for you. You know that, right?
I'm all the way back.
You'll be well, okay?
Thank you so much.
You don't have to. I'm glad it's for you all.
Well done, eh? All the best. Wonderful blessings.
Thank you.
I'm going to see you.
Can I just leave, darling?
Where's she going so quick? Huh?
When are you going to tell
her? You're going too quick. You look sick, Miss Chase.
You look so quick.
Are you okay? Are you okay?